Hey everyone, it's great to have you here. Today we are delving into some really cool updates that have just hit Home Assistant and its latest 2023.9 release. I'm genuinely excited to walk you through the new features and enhancements for onboarding, climate, tile cards, weather forecasts, template sensors and more. Those improvements might just make your smart home experience even better. Let's jump right in. Starting from Home Assistant 2023.9, the onboarding process is updated. This is the second onboarding update in the last several months, so I guess the Home Assistant crew really wants to make this first touch with the product a first-class experience. The onboarding process received a fresh new look and a simplified approach to get you started with Home Assistant in no time. You can change the language right away and there is no more fuzzing around and selecting too many things like default currency, measurement units and stuff like that, as all of this is auto-derived from the country that you select. Next thing worth mentioning is that the compatible integrations that Home Assistant finds in your home are just listed and you can add and configure them at later stage from the integration section, if you wish. Overall, the Home Assistant onboarding just became a straightforward path to getting your smart home up and running, and that is the main priority. The update isn't stopping there. Home Assistant 2023.9 introducing a bunch of new tile cards features that are designed to make your Home Assistant experience more comprehensive and efficient. It's quite a diverse range that can really add depth to your smart home setup and save you a lot of dashboard space at the same time. Also, in Home Assistant 2023.9 and onwards, the more info panels for climate, humidifier and water heater entities got a fresh makeover. And I have to say, it's pretty awesome. The update brings in this stylish circular slider that's all about displaying the current temperature represented as a dot and set points. Plus, there are neat buttons for adjusting those set points. The added glow in the middle, highlighting ongoing actions, adds a nice touch of visual feedback. And before we go further into the Home Assistant 2023.9 goodies, make sure to grab your copy of the Smart Home Glossary, which is packed with explanations of the most common smart home terms and acronyms, perfect for anyone diving into the world of home automation. The link is in the video description below and it is totally free. Bring your umbrellas and get ready for some weather excitement as Home Assistant 2023.9 introduced a weather forecast service. That's a game changer. Instead of hopping between different forecast entities, you can now use the weather.getForecast service to fetch all your weather predictions. Whether you're looking for daily or hourly forecasts, it's all streamlined into one entity. And hey, your weather card on the dashboard is now more customizable too. And you can now pick what kind of weather forecast you want to show in that card. And speaking of weather, outdoor and new additions, say hello to the next update of this release, the lawnmower entity. You can now integrate your lawnmower right into your Home Assistant. Currently, the integration is only possible over MQTT and only the very basic functions are available, such as start, pause and return to home. And there are no areas yet, for example, but nevertheless, it is a promising step and there is a strong hint that more integrations are on the horizon. So, you can keep an eye for those. Here is a handy one. Home Assistant 2023.9 brought preview support for the UI for template sensors. It's really a win-win situation. You get to set the sensor state using templates, choose units of measurements, and set devices and state classes without diving into YAML. Both sensors and binary sensors are supported. While the UI covers most cases, do keep in mind that more advanced attributes still need some YAML magic. Setting up a helper has never been this interactive as it is now in Home Assistant 2023.9. Imagine getting a preview of how your entity will look even before finalizing it. With the new preview feature, you can see exactly how your settings will impact the look of your entity. And to spice things up a bit while talking about groups, there is a new one added. It is called Event Group. And if you're itching to learn more, I've got just the thing for you. Join my upcoming Home Assistant webinar, where we'll be discussing the official installation types and a super simple way to get started on your PC in under 5 minutes. Don't miss out! Sign up today and take your smart home journey to the next level. I'm Kirill, thanks for reaching so far, and please watch my Home Assistant playlist that I made specially for you.